it's a lion and myth that the females do all the hunting and the males just come in once they've made a kill. They don't do that. The lionesses, they do most of the hunting. The males don't hunt as often as what they do. But the main reason for that is that the males have got other things that they do aside from just hunting. A female's main job in life is to have cubs and hunt. That's what she does. The males, they take over territories and they'll control territories. And right now we've got two prides on the property. They've obviously got their cubs who are in shape they are, so they're going to obviously need quite a bit of food to keep their reserves going, so they're going to be hunting primarily most of the time. Now the males, like I was really saying, we've got the two prides. These two guys are actually in charge of both prides. It's not uncommon for coalitions of males to actually be in charge of more than one pride. So they'll be travelling between both groups, they'll be checking females if they're in estrus or not that they can mate with. They'll be making sure there's no other new males that have come in that are potentially competition to try and take over their territory from them. So they actually spend a majority of their time busy walking around, patrolling, making sure that their territories are safe and secure.
One of the females.
No, not actually. When the females go hunting, they take their cubs and they'll, for example, they'll hide them up in the hills. And then they go off and they go hunting, because you'll hear the cubs when they walk, if they start getting tired, you hear them complaining and moaning. So there'll be this general cacophony and complaining and squealing while they're walking. So they obviously, you cannot hunt with that. And what they'll do is they go hide the cubs, they go off, they hunt, if they kill something, then if the cubs are big enough to eat meat, they'll come back and they'll fetch the cubs and then take them to the carcass. Then the cubs will feed. Once the carcass is finished, they'll take the cubs off, hide them again, and then go repeat the process. If the cubs are still very, very small, like what some of these are, they might not be eating meat yet. So what they'll do is they'll feed on the carcass themselves and then come back to the cubs and suck them off. Yes, they do use them as they get older. You'll see on some of the lionesses, the one on the right hand side, you might see one or two faint marks still on the front legs. And even on her hind quarters, you'll see one or two faint marks there. The general rule of thumb is spots will fade with age. And that's why they need to be camouflaged, is when the females leave them by themselves like that, they obviously are vulnerable to other predators.
So other lions? Or?
Other lions, hyenas, buffalo, that sort of a thing.
A buffalo will just trample on them.
Yeah, they'll just crawl and trample off to death. Buffalo and lions aren't big friends, they're in good ring. They've got a very quick gestation period actually. They're pregnant only for about 110 days on average, so it's about 3.5 going on 4 months. A very, very quick gestation period, and they'll give birth to these little blind, helpless cubs in a very secure den site, like I pointed out that hill on the way up. They'll go give birth right up in the top crevices of that hill over there. And the cubs are fairly safe in that area because, like I mentioned, they can't walk, they can't see, their little ears are closed. So it takes them a while before